skates back on stage to see who among them will be the new champion.
And the award goes to Mr. Arjun Gupta.
Welcome back to Storytime, a series where I share interesting stories and experiences from my life that have profoundly shaped the person that I am today. And in today's episode, I'm going to be talking about the time when I won the spelling bee in the third grade. And that was probably the first time that I'd ever tasted any sort of success in my life. And yeah, I'm not going to reveal too much more here. But until then, sit back and enjoy. Ever since I was in like the first grade, my mom had this thing of me being the spelling bee champion. She was like, Arjun beta, you have it in you to be the spelling bee champion. And she made me memorize the spellings of like 10 words every day. So every morning before school, starting from the first grade, she would make me spell out 10 different words. Now, the spelling bee, she said, was going to be held in third grade, which it was. So that would give me about 2.5 years, because the spelling bee is held in the second term of third grade. So I had a full 2.5 years, which is about 1,000 days of preparation. And she said if I learned 10 words a day, the spellings of 10 words a day, I would have learned the spellings of 10,000 words at the end of those 2.5 years. So she was relentless. We never skipped a day. And wait, actually, no, we did skip maybe 3-4 days in the whole process. But she made sure that if we ever missed a day, we would do 20 words the next day. And this has been a wonderful lesson, which has served me well later on in life as well, where if I miss a day with my regular routine, not a big deal, but I get back on track and compensate by doing more the next day. We practiced and practiced and practiced. My mom would not let me go until I was absolutely perfect with the spelling of the words. And she also made sure I was confident, because she was saying that stuttering and all of this is not going to help me in the competition. And she said, in practice, you have to be impeccable, because my mom always told me that in competitions, you know, anxiety, nerves, etc., they can potentially kick in. So that can negatively affect your performance just a little bit. So in practice, you have to be impeccable. So we would practice every single day. Finally, in the second term of third grade, the spelling bee came about, and I was really excited. So there were 3 rounds in the spelling bee. The first one was in the classroom. So in the third grade, there were about 6 sections with about 20 to 30 kids per class. So it was about 120 to 180 children in the whole third grade. Now in the class, they were going to select the top 4 contestants. Now the rule is very simple. They're just going to go around asking spelling. So they basically make you sit in a circle and then they ask you to spell a particular word. If you misspell it, you're out. So it was like, you know, you can't even make a single mistake. One mistake and you're gone. So I was nervous, but at the same time, I knew that I'd been preparing for this since first grade, because my mom had this idea that Arjun is going to be a spelling bee champion. And guys, I feel like that self-belief definitely helped me a lot in navigating that. I didn't know it at the time, but now that I reflect back on that time, I can definitely see it. So I got through the first round. The second round was then amongst all the people who qualified from the respective classes. So there would be 24 final people. And from that, there would be the top 3 who would qualify to the final round. So same format, they would go around a circle asking you to spell words. One mistake, just one tiny little mistake, even if it's just one singular letter, whatever, even if, and also there was one more thing where you had to pronounce the word right. So if you just mispronounce the word, you're gone. I was scared, but again, I was able to clear it. So guys, I didn't let that intimidate me, the whole mistake thing. I was just focused on spelling each word that came my way correctly, because I knew that I'm not going to lose. See, that's the thing in competitions such as this, when there are lots of people, just don't lose. Don't make a mistake. If you do that long enough, you'll stay in the game. And just like that, I got into the final round with the top three contestants. And that was a nail biter. You know, nobody was making mistakes. But guys, I wanted that spelling bee. You know, my dad had also promised me a pizza party. For some of you guys, as some of you guys may know, I used to love pizza back in the day. I still do. I've found healthy vegan versions of pizza now, so I enjoy that. But I used to love pizza back in the day and even Coke. So my dad promised me a pizza and ice cream party. So I was motivated to win that spelling bee. And I was like, I'm not losing. I'm going to get every single spelling right. And I did just that. So the first guy was eliminated. And it was just me and this Korean guy. He was really smart. He was a good friend of mine, James. So it was just me and James. James, if you're watching this, what's up? It was just us left. Again, we went back and forth. He wasn't messing up. I wasn't messing up. But there was one word which he ended up messing up. And the thing in the finals that's different is if someone messes up a word, you have to spell that word correctly. And if you can spell that word correctly, you're the winner. So I just had to spell one word right. And then I would be crowned spelling bee champion. I actually took a deep breath. I don't even know how I knew about that, because I didn't know about meditation, breath work, or any of these other things which I know about today and talk about on this channel. But somehow I just took a few deep breaths. I spelled that word. I pronounced it super correctly, just as if I was pronouncing any other word. I didn't even think of the fact that the spelling bee victory was on the line. And just like that, the judges were like, "That's right, Arjun, your boy was spelling bee champion." I was crowned the spelling bee champion of the Graded School of Sao Paulo in the third grade. That was probably the first success I'd ever tasted in my life. And I gotta say, guys, it was absolutely wonderful. Obviously, my dad gave me a pizza party. It was wonderful. I still remember it to this day. The neighbors and everybody, all of my friends were congratulating me. Actually, in Brazil, where we were living, all my neighbors were like part of the Indian community. So we had this nice interconnected Indian community. So we were all friends. So, you know, everyone was really happy for me. And yeah, my mom was the happiest, because it started off as her dream, but then it became mine as well, because she knew I had it in me all along. Through this entire experience, I learned the value of practice. If you just repetitively do something so much, A, you'll be very confident, and B, you know, your chances of winning are just going to go up massively. And as I said, there is a certain level of confidence that comes from preparation. I had probably learned 10,000 different words over the 1,000 days, because we would just do 10 words a day. It also shows the power of micro habits, or atomic habits, as James Clear talks about in his book. By the way, guys, get the book Atomic Habits. It's absolutely wonderful. But yeah, just doing small things every day, taking small actions towards your goals, can have a massive impact. See, because 10 words doesn't seem like a lot, right? It's not daunting. Obviously, if you say, "Oh, I gotta do 10,000 words, that might turn you off. But if you just say, "I have to do 10 words a day," that's definitely manageable, and that's something we all can do. So I think setting small targets is the key, and if you do that, you can do anything. The spelling bee is something which I'm never going to forget. It's also helped me a lot in school, because I wasn't the best student in English, but that was because of other reasons like grammar and that kind of stuff. But I never ever made spelling mistakes on an English exam. So if you look at any of my English exams from the first grade to the 12th grade, even now in my college, there is not a single spelling mistake. Even in all the papers and assignments that I've turned in, there's never a spelling mistake. So I'm very grateful to have participated in the spelling mistake, and yeah, it served me well to this day. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.